Welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today we have a question was sent in, and I'm not positive that I have the best or the right answer, and so I'm going to ask for help from anyone out there. If you have a question or if you have input on this particular podcast, please feel free to drop us an email, bill@MrExcel.com. The question that came in involves the scroll bar along the right-hand side. So here I've kind of minimized this window so you can see that basically, in this case, the scroll bar takes up almost half the window, and you can very easily scroll through the portion of the spreadsheet that has data. It's very easy to do. But if we would happen to go to the last row of data, hit the end key and then the down arrow keys that were the last row in the spreadsheet, now you see that the spreadsheet scroll bar slider has become incredibly small. And it becomes a big hassle to basically even grab the thing so we can go back up to the top of the spreadsheet. Now it's interesting, in Excel 2003, once I've gotten to the top of the spreadsheet, it becomes normal size. But sometimes we might have a data set. In this case, you can see there's 18 rows in the data set, yet the scroll bar remains incredibly small. Now, my one trick for this is that we want to see what the real last row of the spreadsheet is. And the way that I do that is I hit the end key, the END key on the keyboard, and then the home key. And that takes us to what Excel believes is the real last cell in the spreadsheet. And in this case, I have 18 rows of data, but for some reason, Excel thinks that the spreadsheet is alive out to J701. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually delete those rows. I'm going to hold on the Shift key, End, and then Up arrow to basically select rows 701 through 19. And I'll use Edit, Delete Row, Entire Row, in order to delete those cells. It also believed that everything out to column J was alive. So if you use Control Home to go to the first cell, there's two extra columns, I and J, which are not filled in this spreadsheet, and we can delete those. So Edit, Delete Column. Now, this in and of itself does not fix the problem. We actually have to go to File, Save, and save the document. And now you see that Excel realizes that our scroll bar comes back to normal size. I wonder if you have any tricks for making the scroll bar come back to the right size after you've accidentally activated too many rows. If you do, let me know, and we'll put it on a future podcast. Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.